Last week, Donald Trump tried to pull off one of the biggest cons of his campaign yet. He tried to convince everyone that he wasn't the one who started the birther movement, and that, in fact, it was actually Hillary Clinton's fault. For more on this, it's time for a closer look. Remember, questioning the legitimacy of the first black president was the centerpiece of Donald Trump's political career. It's the thing that made him popular with GOP voters, but during this campaign season, he's refused to discuss the issue at all. And that came to a head on Friday when Trump once again played the media by teasing a big announcement on the birther issue. And the media gamely went along, standing by for an announcement that even they knew was total BS.
A remarkable moment in the history of presidential politics. We believe a presidential candidate is about to stage a grand event in a hotel ballroom to essentially declare the sky is blue, water is wet, and the sun rises in the east. We think that Donald Trump might say that he now thinks that President Obama was born in the United States of America.
But we don't know.
We don't know.
We don't know.
At this point, Trump is effectively giving the news a daily existential crisis. We don't know, man. We just don't know. So the media stood by with bated breath, and once Trump took the stage, he rewarded their patience by immediately getting to the issue at hand, plugging his new hotel in Washington, D.C.
Nice hotel. Under budget and ahead of schedule. Isn't that nice? This is our brand new ballroom. The hotel is completed. We'll be having our opening ceremony in October, and it's going to be something very special. I really believe, I said, this will be the best hotel in Washington.
Washington? If Trump wins, he should build hotels in Canada. After the election, demand's going to be huge. Nobody's going to want to go to Washington. So after a half an hour of free advertising, Trump finally tossed the media the bone they've been waiting for, a 30-second statement with no apology that falsely claimed it was Hillary Clinton who started the birther movement in the first place.
Hillary Clinton and her campaign of 2008 started the birther controversy. I finished it. You know what I mean. President Barack Obama was born in the United States, period.
Obama was born in the United States, period. You, exclamation point. You don't get to peddle racist rhetoric for 5 years and decide when it's over. We decide when it's over. And it's certainly not over after a 30-second statement in the middle of a hotel commercial.
Also, the Travelocity gnome said all Mexicans aren't rapists, so that's over now, too.
And Obama wasn't born here is your number one hit. Saying you got it from Hillary would be like Springsteen saying he only wrote Born to Run because he heard Bon Jovi say it once. And Trump isn't exactly being shy about how he's manipulating the media either. In fact, he's bragging about it. After the event, he actually retweeted an article headlined, Donald Trump's birther event is the greatest trick he's ever pulled. He's bragging about tricking us. It's like when Kaiser Soze tweeted, I was Kevin Spacey the whole time. And that's basically what this entire birther saga is, another trick by Donald Trump. But Trump isn't David Copperfield or David Blaine. He's your uncle telling you he's got your nose. Because now, Trump and his campaign are trying to trick people into thinking that Trump stopped his birther rhetoric after 2011, a claim Chris Christie made yesterday, even after being directly contradicted.
After the president presented his birth certificate, Donald has said, you know, he was born in the United States, and that's the end of the issue.
Just as a point of fact, again, Donald Trump did not accept when Barack Obama released his birth certificate in 2011. He kept up this whole birther thing until Friday. That's 5 years. But we only have a little time left, so I want to ask you.
But Jake, that's just not true. It's just not true that he kept it up for 5 years. It's just
sure
simply
did.
Not true.
It is true.
It wasn't like he was talking. No, Jake, it wasn't like he was talking about it on a regular basis until then. And when the issue was raised, he made very clear the other day what his position is.
Now, before we unload on Chris Christie for being a liar, it's important to remember this is a difficult time for him. According to today's New York Times, prosecutors now say Chris Christie knew about the Bridge Lane closings as they happened. And say what you will about Hillary's email server, it never stuck an ambulance in traffic, you cartoon gangster. Of course, this New York Times report will come as no surprise to the politician who last December said The George Washington Bridge, he knew about it. He knew about it, totally knew about it. And which politician was that?
The George Washington Bridge. He knew about it. He knew about it. He totally knew about it.
So the liar hired the other liar to basically work as a greeter at Lie-Mart. Because only a Lie-Mart greeter would claim Trump didn't talk constantly about the birther issue for the last 5 years when, thanks to cameras, we know he did.
People have birth certificates. He doesn't have a birth certificate.
A lot of people do not think it was an authentic certificate.
Donald, you're beginning to sound a little ridiculous. I have to tell you.
I think you are. Wolf, let me tell you something. I think you sound ridiculous.
You don't still question that he was born in the United States, do you?
I have no idea. You know, some people say that was not his birth certificate. The president should come clean.
But he is a citizen. He produced that long form birth cert.
Well, a lot of people don't agree with you, and a lot of people feel it wasn't a proper certificate.
Whether or not that was a real certificate, because a lot of people question it, I certainly question it. Now all we have to do is find out whether or not it was real.
He was still saying the birth certificate could be fake last year. And by the way, I'm not sure the guy who holds fake press conferences, has a fake university, a fake foundation, fake hair, and a fake tan should be the one in charge of deciding what's real. And even if there hadn't been cameras recording Trump's birtherism the past 5 years, there are his tweets, which, unlike whispered sweet nothings from summers long past, are saved and archived, like this one from 2012. An extremely credible source has called my office and told me that Barack Obama's birth certificate is a fraud. Because if an extremely credible source had evidence in 2012 that the president was a fraud, their first thought would be, I should call a game show host. Or this 2013 tweet, how amazing, the state health director who verified copies of Obama's birth certificate died in plane crash today, all others lived. Let's just step back here and think about how insane that is. Trump thinks the president orchestrated a plane crash so accurate that it only killed the one person who could prove his birth certificate was a fraud. Yeah, just bang the plane against a mountain, but then landed safely. 12E. We want to take out 12E. And it wasn't just Obama's birth certificate. Trump also questioned the legitimacy of his college records and his acceptance into Columbia, like when he tweeted in 2012, isn't it time that Obama released his college records and applications? Boy, would that create a mess. He is not who you think. Or this, why won't Obama release his college applications? Is there something foreign about them? Whereas Trump's college application was probably just a wad of cash stuffed in the dean's golf bag. And let's be clear, it wasn't just Trump. The Republican Party saw that a large percentage of their base had bought into this racist conspiracy theory and that it was propelling Trump to political stardom. And what did they do? Not only did they not denounce it, they tolerated and even encouraged it for years.
Now, I don't assert where he was born. I will just tell you that we are all certain that he was not raised with an American experience.
I wish this president would learn how to be an American.
That kind of ignorance about whether he's a Muslim doesn't concern you?
Listen, the American people have the right to think what they want to think.
No one's ever asked to see my birth certificate. They know that this is the place that we were born and raised.
Well, that's because Romney didn't have a birth certificate. He had an owner's manual. When Romney was born, he came with a USB cable and a surge protector. The bottom line is this. Trump built his career on a racist lie because he's a racist and a liar. And instead of denouncing that lie, the GOP doubled down on it completely. And now Trump is trying to trick people once again by convincing them he was never really a birther at all and that it was Hillary Clinton who started it. Which brings me back to the event at his hotel. You know, the brand new ballroom that was under budget and ahead of schedule? Well, once Trump left the stage, things fell apart, literally.
It's important to note that Hillary Clinton has given, and the stage is falling apart behind us.
The only way that could have been more on the nose is if the banner said, "This is a metaphor." This has been a closer look.